And with that, I will hand over the proceedings to our esteemed moderator, Mr. Ron Pernick. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a big round of applause for the esteemed panelists and our chair and our moderator, please.
Welcome, everyone. So this is the Disruptive Technologies panel. And one thing that I wanted to do, in the United States, when we have panels, we have a lot of interaction. So we have a lot of people on stage that might be a little difficult to do today. Everyone who's wanting to come in, please come in and come on down further if you want to be closer to all of us. But what I wanted to say is that if we can, we're going to try to have a conversation as well. We'll see if we get to that. It may be difficult, but the panelists and I got together this morning, most of us, some of you are new faces, and we've agreed to limit each presentation to 10 minutes. So they're going to target 7 to 10 minutes. That's sort of the game rules that we're going to operate under. And hopefully we'll get there. There'll be someone down here, guys, with a placard. So when you get to the 1 minute mark, that'll show up. So let me just say, in being at this event so far, it's clear that we're seeing disruption across the utility sector. It's happening both at the large scale, utility generation and transmission, and then all the way to the grid edges. And in particular, I think we're seeing the most disruption at those outer edges of the grid. So today we've got a great panel. I've seen a lot of their presentations. As was said earlier, we're going to delve into blockchain, AI, the electrification of everything, and much more. So with that, I'd like to move to our panelists. We're going to start with Oriol from the Energy Web Foundation, and again, try to keep it pretty quick, and then hopefully have a nice conversation. Oriol?